I am your father.
Hello, everybody. My name's Ben Robbins from The Lost World of Movie Props. I'm here today with David Stone. How are you doing, sir?
I'm fine, Ben. How are you?
I'm very good, thank you. So are you enjoying yourself today? Been busy?
Yeah, I mean, not too bad. I mean, what can you say? Yeah. It's been all right. Waiting for the rush.
Yeah, of course. So did you always want to be an actor growing up, or did you fall into the roles?
I went to drama school, and after that, I was coming to the end of drama school, and then they were doing an audition at Elstree for this first Star Wars, A New Hope.
Yeah.
And The New Hope entailed wearing a rubber head, which I think you know.
Yeah.
You see me in that head. They called it the actual head, the multi-eyed creature. And if you see the head, you know why,
because
it's got about 10 eyes and tentacles either side.
Yeah.
Blah, blah, blah. And then when Lucas realized what was going on, because this was A New Hope, the first one ever made, he then decided to give us all contracts and character names.
Yeah.
Because those heads were just, you know, not, like I said, a multi-eyed creature. So I was given the name of Wyostley, which was a very strange name. And this was the one that involved the land speeder being sold when we went to Tunisia in the desert. I expect you've seen that scene.
Yeah,
you?
Of course.
And which was very nice, very hot. The mask head, it was a head really. It just fitted over. It was like a rubber head that went straight over your head. I had a mold done for it. It was most uncomfortable. The holes at the front, I used to put a couple of straws up to have a drink.
Nice.
Because you couldn't keep taking the head off in between shots. It was just so difficult. So basically, we had it on for about 4 or 5 hours.
Oh, wow.
So it was miserable. Sweat used to be dripping underneath, you can imagine. Most uncomfortable. And then, of course, in the cantina scene, where we were all in the disco, you can imagine with all the smoke, you know, because they had all smoke, you know, special effects.
Yeah.
With the head, smoke, heat, it was just unbearable.
Yeah.
And you couldn't wait for 1 o'clock, because you used to go in 6 o'clock call in the morning. And then usually have it on 4 or 5 hours and then break for lunch.
Yeah.
Then, of course, you took it off. Back again, 2 o'clock, same old rigmarole. But it was it was good fun. There was a lot of the small people there as well.
Yeah.
Kenny Baker and some of the others. Of course, Dave Prowse has gone now, and the other one, Bullock, Jeremy Bullock. And then, of course, when that came to an end, A New Hope, he then was doing two others back to back. He basically did, then he went on to Return of the Jedi and then Empire Strikes Back, which he gave me a couple of small parts on that as a B-wing.
Yeah.
I was a B-wing in Return of the Jedi and then doubled also for Mark Hamill in a couple of scenes while Mark was away. I mean, I was stuck up in a spaceship in Elstree, sort of 40 foot up in the air in one of the hangars.
Awesome.
I mean, it was pretty good because the orange, you know, when you're that far away, you can double for anyone. So Mark was in Los Angeles, and I suppose I looked a bit similar to him. And so they kept me up there for that. And then, for some reason, you know, we were like a little Star Wars family, because then he kept the people who were in that one to go on to Empire.
Yeah.
And then I was an X-Wing in Empire Strikes Back. Most of them were all done, But they're all done in the UK, Elstree Studio. A lot of people think that Star Wars is American.
Yeah, I've heard that so many times from people. Yeah. It's crazy.
But it does give the impression for some reason it is American, but it's not. But of course, the franchise now has been taken over by Disney. Yeah. So I suppose that's why a lot of people automatically think that it was made in America. But in fact, it was all made to the credit of the British film industry in the UK.
Yeah.
In Elstree, and there's bits and pieces done in location, and then Tunisia. And so that's basically where I did a few other bits and pieces after Star Wars, and I was the best man at Brigitte Bardot, and then I worked on The Stud with Joan Collins.
Wicked, nice. Fun. That's really cool, yeah, with Joan Collins,
You watched it?
I haven't seen it for a while, but I remember seeing it, yeah.
And then I sort of came out of that business, and I did work on behind the scene. I worked as a location manager for the BBC after that. Excuse me, and then got made redundant, and then moved to the West Country. I thought, well, what shall I do now with my life? So I bought a holiday complex in Devon, which I've since sold.
Yeah,
and moved back to the southeast, and therefore it's enabled me to do a tickle in my throat. Excuse me.
We've got some water down there. If you want some water,
it's enabled me now to do the comic conventions, which I've been doing the last 3 or 4 years all over the world.
Oh, wow. Nice.
You know, I've been doing them a lot in America, Canada, Europe. And anybody who's had anything to do with Star Wars is really sought after because there's such a big following for it. That's the thing. And you admire the people that follow it because you think, well, there's an awful lot of autistics, but people, but if it makes them happy, why not?
Yeah.
And there's nothing wrong. You know, everyone's just got to get pleasure out of life somewhere. And if following Star Wars, you know, people, the characters, it's good. Anyway, have you got anything else to ask?
I was going to say, like, so obviously you come onto the convention scenes now, so getting to meet fans, have that interaction, how's that been for you? Is that a completely different world you've discovered?
What do you mean?
So obviously, like, you said you've been doing it 3 years now, so what's it been like sort of discovering that people all around the world want to meet you and see you because of Star Wars, and it's still popular today? And
yeah, it's exactly. It makes you realise how well Star Wars is thought about by many of the population. Yeah, I mean, it's amazing. So, you know, some of them, they've turned up. I was in, New York, Nashville, Buffalo, Vancouver. I did some conventions just before lockdown. And all of a sudden I looked and I thought, I've seen you before. So a lot of the guys who follow you, they seem to pop up everywhere. But then saying that, if that makes them happy, who am I to judge what they're doing?
Yeah, of course.
But in the same breath, what I did in Star Wars and all the publicity shots I've got, I can't make any more. So there, as they, you know, that's how it is.
Yeah.
So they've got them. And but I'm sure it's just, it's something that I think it's a sort of a Star Wars nostalgia thing with people. You either got it or you haven't got it. If you don't, you know, some people like Star Trek, Doctor Who, Harry Potter.
Yeah.
They follow all that.